On this episode of For Fun Flyer, installing the transponder antenna, making a cockpit panel wire jack, and installing the avionics onto the cockpit panels. Hi guys, welcome back to another day doing maintenance and doing work on the TL-96 Papotel 3 Golf 2. And I'm again busy with doing work on the cockpit panel with the wiring, etc., and all the work to draw out the cutout shape of the new panels. So it's a lot of work doing this kind of stuff, and it's somewhat demotivating because you have to undo all the wiring, etc., etc. A new day, a new set of jobs I want to do on my airplane in order to get her flying again. And what I want to try to do today is all the preparation work for the installation of the transponder. My airplane didn't come with an already installed transponder, so that's something I have to do all by myself. And as you might know already, every transponder needs an antenna. So I have to figure out a decent spot to install this antenna somewhere at the bottom side of this airplane and run some wiring, etc. I'll have to figure out if I have everything I'll need for that too. But one of the biggest things is to install the antenna correctly so the transponder can do its job. Other stuff is the wingtip light. I prepared some stuff for that as well. I prefabricated some audio harnesses for the headsets. So those are brand new too. I want to run an extra wire, the supply wire, to the first circuit breaker of the airplane. So there's a lot of stuff I want to try to get done today, but let's see what I can actually do. After some consideration, I think this is the best spot, somewhere here at this section of the fuse, to drill the transponder antenna, because it has to be fitted at the bottom side of the airplane, and this compartment is the most accessible part of the bottom side of the airplane, right below the main spars. And I think the best way to go is to drill a hole right here, and at this way I don't need to use very long coax cables, which reduces the output power of the transponder too, of course. So I think that's the best way to go here and make a ground plane. I'll explain it, that in a couple of seconds, what it actually is, and I think that's the best way to go. So I briefly mentioned the ground plane I had to make for the transponder antenna, and that's basically a conducting plate that is situated on top of the transponder antenna like this, at the fuse side of things. And the purpose of it is to reflect the radio waves that come off from the dipole antenna and reflect them to the ground, and to shield the occupants from the radio waves. But I have to figure out a way to cut this at the right size and to make a hole big enough that I can connect it via wire or conducting tape, because the fuse is too thick to bond them all together at once. So let's see how that goes. So after drawing the cockpit panels for my new airplane and test cut them on my own laser cutter in a cardboard, I received the cockpit panels from a company nearby that routed them out of aluminum. The cockpit panels basically are ready to get all the components installed onto. and run some wiring. So it's always a bit of a hassle to have separate cockpit panels and what to do where exactly. So you basically you don't want to do all the work in the airplane because it's not really comprehensive. You get have to get in and out of the airplane like a gazillion times, and it's not really comprehensive. So all the work you can prepare out of the cockpit is a gain. So I came up with this solution. Let me show you. I prepared installation and wiring jig. So basically, it's a piece of plywood with three holes in them, shaped into the three cockpit panels, and the cockpit panels will be installed in these holes, and it allows me to run all the wiring on all the pitot static hoses from panel to panel and really prepare them for installation into the airplane. And the final thing, hopefully the final thing I have to do when I ran all the wiring and hosing, is just do a sort of transplantation from this mounting jig or wiring jig onto the airplane. And I think this way it will save me a lot of time. So let's get going with sawing this jig. So after half an hour, three quarters of an hour of cutting off some plywood, this is the end result of the wiring jig. So as you can see, it has some side panels to keep it upright, so it doesn't have a tendency to flip over. And I cut the edges of the holes somewhat more precise. And some of you might notice that the gap between the cockpit panels is somewhat large, or larger than in the real airplane. So at the real cockpit, this is about 8 centimeters more to the front than the rest of the panel. So by placing this these two panels further apart, I have the spacing I need for the wiring. So I can wire all the harnesses flat to the surface of the wiring jig and have enough room in the actual setup of the airplane. Again, a little status update on the work on the cockpit panels. As you can see right here, I installed the cockpit panels onto my wiring jig, which proves to be very, very valuable and saves me a lot of time already. And I did a lot of work already, of course, on the panels themselves. So, and to be honest, I was so enthusiastic working on these panels, I didn't document every step of the way. Sorry for that, but you'll get a pretty good idea what I did over here, of course, with this panel. And what I did here was just install the instruments and made some additions to the setup with an extra push-to-talk button and some alarm lights, and that was basically it. And the pitot static I'll show you in a couple of minutes what I did at the backside of this panel. The mid panel right here is the panel where the iPad is situated. That's my MFD almost for navigation purposes and etc. So that will run Sky Demon. Then we've got over here a slot for the VHF radio, the transponder, and all the switches of all the electric components of the airplane, right? So this is the main and starter with the key switch, of course, and the magnetos, fuel pump, lights. Those are the combination of rear position navigation strobe lights, the landing lights in front of the cowl, and then the EVIS radio, transponder, GPS for the activation of the little cooling fan, and also the charging USB port for charging the iPad in mid-flight. And then over here you have an extra switch for the USB port. That's an auxiliary port on the right hand side panel to be switched on and off mid-flight. So that's that panel. So this is right hand side panel, which consists of the engine monitor device, some spare room for future updates whenever needed, and also the same setup: the generator, warning light, alarm, the generic warning or alarm lights, and here to an extra push-to-talk button, the circuit breakers, and the USB charging port right here. So I showed you the front side of the wiring jig in the last section of this video, this episode. This is the back side at this moment of the wiring jig, and as you can see, this is the left hand panel, of course, with all the instruments. So for the people that aren't into avionics that much, I prepared the pitot static. Those consist of two separate pneumatic systems, of course. One is attached to the pitot tube on the wing to measure the pressure inside of the pitot tube to determine the airspeed, indicated airspeed. And there's, of course, the reference line, which consists of the surrounding air pressure of the aircraft. So, and as you can see, one line runs to only these two instruments. Let me aim a bit. So that's this line that's attached to this port and this port. The line that connects all the instruments, that's the static port. And for the airspeed indicator right here, and the Garmin G5 EVIS, it's the reference air pressure for determining the right indicated airspeed. So this is the backside of the center panel. And as you already saw in the last section of the video, the cooling fan of the iPad. This is the installation tray of the radio, VHF radio, and below it is the installation of the installation tray of the transponder. And I have to figure out a way, and that's up next, to finish up the installation of that device. So I've got a install a hose connector for the static air pressure, of course, because it's a altimeter encoding transponder, and also the coax connector, PNC connector, and also the other electrical connectors. And that's all in this little bag right here, so that's a bit of a puzzle, but I'll manage, no worries. And at this side of the wiring jig, that's the right hand side panel, of course, we've got the engine instrument, and that's pretty much already done, because I left the connectors inside the airplane. Probably we'll have to rewire the mains power supply of the device. And the wires you see right here are the wires that, let me aim the camera a bit, that wire the push-to-talk button and the alarm LEDs indicators over here. And of course, we've got here the backside of the circuit breakers. So that's basically it. The circuit breakers feed these switches, and these switches feed all the separate devices right here. So that's the idea, at least. So let's see how things evolve. I would like to end this episode with an overview of all three cockpit panels, starting with the center cockpit panel, and after that the left-hand side cockpit panel with the analog instruments, the EVIS, and to end with the right-hand side cockpit panel with the engine instrument and the circuit breakers. That's it for this episode. Again, thanks for watching. If you liked this episode, please hit the thumbs up button, as well as the subscribe and the notification button.
Any questions or comments on this episode, share them in the comment section of this video. Don't miss out on the next episode. Check out the website for funflyer.com for more info and the monthly contest. And as always, I hope to see you next time. Fly safe.